Hello, I'm Heather Rose, and together with Brand Tasmania, I've made a little list of recommendations for books that you might like to read in the coming months. It's really going to take something for us all to stay safe and stay inside, so reading is a wonderful way to while away the hours. So here are a few recommendations. A book of incredible historical importance, Truganini by Cassandra Pybus, about one of our most famous Indigenous ancestors. Cassandra has written a number of very good books of history. She's an eminent historian, and this is an extremely important story for all of us Tasmanians and people who are interested in the history of Tasmania. Truganini by Cassandra Pybus. This book came out a little while ago, but I really wanted to mention it. Christine Milne, another very important Tasmanian. Christine was the leader of the Greens. She has given her life to activism and the environment on the world stage, as well as here in Tasmania and more widely in Australia. This book is really beautiful because it's told through artifacts and items in Christine's life that tell the story of her life. It's about women and politics and all that it takes to take a very private person into the public arena. So enjoy this book, it's very special. Flightlines by Andrew Darby, another non-fiction book that has only recently been released. Andrew is a journalist by trade, but he's taken a subject that's very dear to his heart, migratory shorebirds, and written us an account of migratory shorebirds through his own personal journey as he's researched this. As we know in Tasmania, we have migratory shorebirds who go from the furthest reaches of Tasmania and even further south to the furthest reaches of the Northern Hemisphere. They're incredible, incredible creatures. We're so blessed to live in a world with such diversity and magic. That has become evident, hasn't it? How much we are connected by nature in the world. This is a really beautiful book. Enjoy. Now for a fiction book that's very special. There Was Still Love by Fable Parrot. This book just won the Independent Bookseller of the Year Award. It's a beautiful evocation of family. It's about family that's separated through war and politics. And it's also about the stories we tell as family that go on through generations. It's exquisitely written. It really is beautiful literary fiction. It's only slender. It won't take you long, but you'll never forget it. Another beautiful bit of literary fiction by another friend of mine, Rowan Wilson. Rowan came to our attention with his first novel, The Roving Party, because it won the Vogel Award. Really great historical fiction. Then he wrote a second book of historical fiction called To Name Those Lost, which was set in Launceston in Tasmania in the 1870s. And now he's leapt 200 years forward to 2075. He's still in Tasmania. And he's given us a vision that we do not want to come true. However, it's a fantastic read, beautifully imagined, good characters, a really great read. To Name the Daughter of Bad Times by Rowan Wilson. Two more books are from an author of historical fiction so far, Lenny Bartolin. Lenny is a Tasmanian. His first novel was Infamy. I really love this. And Fortune, both of them are set in the 1700s and 1800s and give us incredible insights into world history, but also Tasmanian history during that time. These are so rich in character. They're rich in craft. Imagine Martin Scorsese wrote novels. This is what it feels like. I love Lenny's work. Enjoy discovering those. Another great Tasmanian writer, David Owen, has been giving us enormous amounts of pleasure with his crime fiction for many years. And this is his latest, A Second Hand. David is dry, he's funny, he's surprising, and his crime fiction is really excellent. So David Owen, A Second Hand. another friend, Catherine Scholes. Catherine is better known in Europe than she is here in Australia, but she deserves to be better known. She writes exquisite romantic fiction that is highly intelligent, beautifully realised, always gives us something very rich in its storytelling. And this is no exception. I really love this book, beautiful escapism, but one that I learn things from. It's about the birth of humanity. It's about tenderness and love and what it takes to be family. It's coming out on Mother's Day this year, so please order it in from your local bookstore. We're so going to need to keep supporting local bookstores. They're such an important part of the fabric of our community. And for us writers in Australia, they are the lifeblood of our readership. So please support your local bookstores. Lots of them have a flat rate for postage at the moment, and will also deliver sometimes for free, of course, if they're in your local area. So please keep up buying your books from your local bookstore. And on Mother's Day, this is a perfect book to give the mother you love. The Beautiful Mother by Catherine Scholes. Rachel Treasure, a Tasmanian treasure. Many years ago, Rachel invented a romantic form of literature about agriculture that she coined as chook lit. And she's continued to write us beautiful stories, fantastic books, great bits of escapism. This is her latest, White Horses. Rachel Treasure, enjoy. Really good to take your mind off everything that is going on at the moment. And another book that's in the romantic fiction genre, Mini Dark. Mini Dark is also my dear friend Danielle Wood. Danielle and I have shared a children's series together under the pseudonym of Angelica Banks. And Danielle has decided to write romantic fiction under the name of Mini Dark. The first of those was Star-Crossed. It's a very funny, beautifully woven story, so cleverly plotted, great characters. And of course it went out around the world and caused a huge wave of affection. And now The Lost Love Song has just come out last week. It is, again, I'm only halfway through it, and it's great. She's so good at storytelling. She's great at plot, she's great at character, and she keeps you guessing right to the end. So please enjoy The Lost Love Song by Danielle Wood. And here are our children's series right here. I thought I would mention these because so many of you are going to be home with children. These are for primary age readers from sort of grade 3 to grade 6, depending on how confident your young reader is. And they're great to read to your children. I'll also be reading these live very soon in the coming weeks. So please look up my social media channels and track these down if you would like your child to have a listen to these being read. And they're an adventure series, but one of the reasons I mention them now is they're about creativity and the power of imagination. Everything that's going to keep us going in the next few months is born of creativity. So the books you read, the music you listen to, the podcasts you listen to, the TV shows that keep you entertained, the movies, the video games, so much of what will keep us sane and keep us inspired and keep us going over the next few months comes from creativity and the arts. And these books are to celebrate young writers and also readers who love a great adventure series. They've been enormously popular. So if you've got a young writer in your family or someone who just loves to read, this series is to be recommended from other readers, not so much the author. And I thought I'd just mention my latest novel, Bruny. Many of you will have read this already. It's set in Tasmania. It's set a little bit ahead and a little bit to the side of current times. It's a love letter to my fellow Tasmanians. It's also a cautionary tale. It's a political thriller. It's a family saga and it's a love story. So if you like a bit of escapism with a little bit of bite, I think you will like Bruny. It suits the zeitgeist right now, is what people are telling me. I get a letter nearly every day to tell me how prescient Bruny is. Enjoy. It is really going to take something to get through the next few months, to keep us all safe, to look after our elderly, to look after our young people, to look after the vulnerable people in our society. So I wish you and your loved ones all the very best. Please stay safe, please stay indoors, please really protect yourselves, and all my love through the coming months.